What's up guys, Ratha here again. This is part two of the drone modeling series where I go in and sketch and define my layout sketches after I've inserted the images. The purpose of this step is to capture all the critical dimensions of the part. By sketching and dimensioning these sketches up front, it will make it easier to make changes down the road because you're building intelligence into these sketches. So I would advise you to spend as much time as possible to get the exact curve you want, whether it be using a figuring out what spline to use to exactly match a curve or adding construction geometry for the setup. If you haven't seen part one, go check it out here and follow along. I left links in the description for the following files below. Now with that out of the way, let's get into it.
Okay, so the first thing you want to do is make sure you're in millimeters. So just go down here, select millimeters. Okay, so now that you have your layout sketch images all configured, now is to create a layout sketch with all the dimensions. And I usually spend a lot of time setting this up. What this does is it adds intelligence to the model. So if I wanted to make changes to something, I can change it in the layout sketch portion. So to do that, instead of sketching onto these images, what I normally do is just create another sketch. And I like to start with the right plane. The reason why is it gives me the most information versus the front or top. So that's just for this particular case. So we'll go right. Since we're going to be focusing only on the main body today, we're just going to be drawing the main body. And then in the next series, I'll be adding all the other stuff like the wing and propeller. Let's start with a line first. There. And let's go with a spline. Make sure this is vertical. And we're gonna make this tangent. Then we're just gonna, let's lock this guy in real quick. So I kind of put it here because you can see this is where the curvature starts. So let's lock in that dimension. Let's make this 397. And let's scoot this guy in a little bit as well. All right, we're going to make this. Let's just go 1,000. Okay. And we're going to grab this. If you don't see these control points, make sure you go in, right click the spline, and make sure you say, I believe it's display control polygons. So make sure you select that. So when you see this, you'll see these control points right here. So this yellow and yellow here. So now I'll just adjust up. Oh, it's acting kind of weird. Okay. To kind of match the curvature. And you want to get close. You want to get, you want to get perfect. So that looks good to me. And I'm going to constrain this a little bit further. So I'm going to add a construction center line. Grab that there. Snap it. Make this tangent. And just kind of tweak the model. And then I'm also going to add another center line there. And add an angle. So let's make this 38. You can see the influence of this angle changes the influence of the spline. So let's go 39. So actually, let's go the other way, 37. Okay, I like that. And let's bring it down there. And I think that looks good for the spline. Okay, now we wanna also add this line here. This is going to be the bottom half, and then let's dimension that. So let's say that's 286. Bring this guy forward, bring this 5 down, and let's make these vertical. Select 2, make that vertical. Let's close this guy in just for, yep. Then now we're gonna wanna add this bottom curve down here. So it's the same thing, just gonna add a line. And it seems like it stops around here, so I'll say right there. Then we'll add another spline. So I'll select somewhere right there, pull it out a little bit, and snap it in to that point. So now we're going to modify this a little bit. Actually, let's make this tangent. Okay, let's actually lock this in. So we're going to give it a dimension. Let's say this is 13. And well, let's say this is 837. And these dimensions won't actually show on the drawing. These are just here so that I can just lock in the dimensions. So. Go there. So you can see it takes some tweaking. So let's go right there. So just grabbing these handles and tweaking it as we go. And to add more control, I'll do another construction line. Make this tangent. And give this also an angle as well. This will just kind of control the spline a little bit further. So we'll say 65. Yep, that looks good. This line here, it's a cut or a trim in the part. So for now, we'll just leave it out. All we're concerned with right now is just the body. So right now, we just care about how everything flows. Okay, and then one more thing I want to do is add the main body attachments, like this portion here, the wing, and this back piece. So let's do that real quick. So we're just going to do a spline. Right now I'm just hitting S. This is just my shortcut so that I don't have to go up here and grab the spline. So let's go there. And the reason why I don't snap it like right here is because sometimes I have a hard time trying to grab the spline handle. So let's hit Control Z, undo that. And I'll actually select it here and just like snap it somewhere in space and then kind of drag it around like this out a little bit. And then let's add that point back to around there. And then I'll massage the spine a little bit. So there, grab these control points. That looks good. And let's also draw the top as well. Same thing, snap it somewhere in space, pull out the handles a little bit, and snap in, make sure those two connect, and then massage the handles to match the blueprint. Okay, that looks good. Let's actually lock this guy in. Say 241, and let's say 687. I think that actually everything kind of moves, so let's hit Control Z. And we'll actually lock this whole thing in real quick. So just do that, grab the origin, let's call this 1613. Okay, looks pretty good. Let's make sure everything is locked. It's not moving. Okay, this spline's not going anywhere. Now we are also going to add this back piece as well. So let's do that. Let's go there. There. Add another spline. Attach that. And we're also going to make this horizontal. So let's grab a construction line, grab this point, make this tangent, tweak if you need to. Okay, that looks good for now. And I'll add this bottom section here on the top view. It makes more sense. Okay, this is good. Like I said, I normally spend a lot of time on my layout sketches, defining them, making sure my curves are exact. It just makes things a lot easier down the road when you need to change something. But just get it right the first time. So spend, like I said, I spend about maybe 10% of my time doing this. Now we need to add the wing portion. So let's do that real quick. Let's just draw a construction line there. And let's do another spline. Sometimes grabbing these spine handles is a little difficult. So snap that in there. Okay. Make sure that's in. Actually, let's dimension this real quick. Just lock it in. 257. And 617. Okay, we'll massage this spline a little bit to match. Okay, it looks good. And let's add another spline. Snapped it into place. And then we're just gonna massage this to kind of match as well. Okay, I think that looks good. Okay, I think we have all our pieces for the right view now. Also, I want to add a construction line to the very top of the point of the drone. This will help me figure out exactly where my front view is going to go, or exactly where my front sketch is going to go. So let's grab that, make that tangent. Now that we have this construction line, I also want to make this the highest point on the spline. So let's grab this point, hold control, and select this and make this coincident. And this will make this the highest point on this part. And then I want to massage this because now I went kind of high back to its point. Scoot this back here and let's dimension that from the origin. Let's call this 443. Okay. We're actually going to be placing a plane here, reference plane here. So that's why that is important, because it adds a node. That's done. Don't forget to save that out now. And let's name this right LO, right layout. Okay. Now let's move over to the top view, as that gives me the second most information. So let's sketch on that top view. Let's draw the body, and I'm actually going to snap to this here because I want to keep that relation. So let's do that. Looks like it changes here. Okay, and we'll add a spline here. Let's make this 86. Let's make this 1,000. Oops. Control Z. 1,000. Okay. Let's make this tangent. Okay. Snap this to the very nose. And let's drag this guy out a little bit to match. Okay, we're also going to add a tangent constraint because we're going to mirror this over. And we also want to add these guys here. So I actually pivot this because I want this to start at the same point here. So let's make this horizontal. Same thing. Horizontal. So now that those are located with that top view or with that right view, grab that, and make this vertical. Then I massage this. Also, we also, since we're gonna mirror this over, we also wanna make these tangent as well. So let's grab that point. Let's add these construction lines here. And let's make this tangent. Tangent. Okay. That looks good. Actually, go a little bit wider there. Okay, that looks good. There. And we actually want to add this back piece, so let's go back into it. Let's add this line. Then add a spline. Like that. And we'll just pull that guy out there. Pull this guy out, kind of massage this to match. And I may need to back this guy up a little bit, so because it's not lining up there exactly. So no problem. Let's go back into that right sketch. Edit sketch. Let's actually push this piece back just a little bit. And a good thing we saw that, because now we want to control that by defining it. Let's give this a dimension of 103. And from here to that, let's give it 119. And we'll make this guy 18 tall. That constrains that a little bit better. Now, let's go back into this. There you go, it's actually lining up a lot better. I like that. Can't forget to add a tangent constraint because we are also mirroring this guy as well. So let's do that tangent. Okay, we're good. And we can also do that here as well. Let's make this tangent. And then let's massage this there. And massage this out a little bit. Okay, that constrains that. Okay, oh, that actually is moving. So let's make that guy horizontal. Okay, that should be it. Now that we have the top, let's label that as top layout. This is how you want to lay out your sketches. You want to pretty much define anything that's pretty much critical. You want to define in your layout sketches before you even start modeling. So in this particular case, the main body is important. The wing where it starts is kind of important. This portion is important, this back piece. So that should give us a good starting point for our surfaces. So normally you want to start with the right. It gives you the most information. And then the top. Also gives you the second most information. And like I said, these dimensions here are only there just to kind of lock in the dimensions and to add intelligence. So let's say if I want to make this wider down the road, I can go into my layout sketches and adjust there. Okay, this is part two of the drone modeling servicing series. So stay tuned for the next one. Also, if I went too fast, just pause a screenshot here of the right view and the top view, and just make sure that your sketch layout has the same dimensions and sketch relations. All right, guys, I know that was pretty boring, but it's essentially for getting this done right up front. I spent about 10% of my time just on this part, just dialing on the dimensions, getting them all right. You know, actually 20% is actually modeling, 30% is actually evaluating, tweaking, you know, so just spend the time to make it right up front. If you like this video, don't forget to give this a thumbs up and subscribe for the next upcoming video. Until next time, I'll see you guys in the next one. Later.